Don't go running your mouth. Don't go running your mouth. It's queer.
I'll break your neck so you can watch your back. Fuck you.
But then he comes in with the
better get them grades up if you wanna finish high school.
Then you're gonna them go chains to your neck, green man.
Voodoo man. Mama took me to the church and I sang a hymn.
I could have got a job at McDonald's, but I like curly fries. I want more.
Ooh, got the feeling. Tell me why. You're watching Two Brains React. This brain is Marlon.
This brain is Liv.
And today we have the new release from Brockhampton.
Ginger. Ginger.
Ginger.
I'm so excited. Oh my god.
Yes, I'm very excited as well. So this is supposed to be this. Are they doing another trilogy thing? So is this after Iridescence or?
I'm not sure because I know when they signed to RCA, they had like a recording contract and they have like a certain amount of albums they have to do.
Right. Yeah.
And that's why Kevin released the solo album because he wanted Brockham to take a break for a bit, and then he came out. He's like, I really shouldn't have done that.
He said he shouldn't have done that.
Yeah, he was like, why? He regrets making the solo album.
Why?
Don't know.
I thought that solo album was pretty good.
It was pretty good.
It was, yeah, it was good.
But Brockhampton is something else. It's something else.
So, yeah, I'm looking forward to this. So this is, it's 12 songs, 44 minutes. Yeah,
I've listened to the, you haven't heard the three singles.
I think, what was the first one that they released? The first one
was, If You Pray Right and I've Been Born Again were released like within like, I think a week of each other.
Okay.
And then Boy Bye came out.
Okay.
Boy Bye is...
So you've listened to all three singles?
I've listened to the three singles.
I listened to the first one once, but yeah. I wasn't really paying attention and I didn't listen to it again. So.
The thing is, because when Boy Bye came out, I don't want to hype it up too much for you, but it blew my mind. I was rinsing it on repeat, so I can't remember the other two singles.
Okay,
because Boy Bye was like, oh my god.
Okay, but you're getting a first reaction from me for basically what
you're saying. Yeah, and Boy Bye is one of the few Brockhampton songs where every performing member and every producer contributes to the song.
Okay.
So everyone's there.
Okay, so the cover, who...
It's Joba and some other guy.
But he's in Brockhampton,
no, he
right?
is, but he's one of the, like, the back, like, behind the scenes dudes. Oh, I don't know his name.
Okay.
Well, a loving, manly embrace.
Yes, it's not like having Amir on the cover. Okay, so the first one is called No Halo. You ready?
No, I'm not.
Okay, let's stop then.
Let's go.
Trying to get that all up in your head again, Montana, Atlanta. Maybe I should just go mosey my ass over to your house. Baby, wanna raid the whole apartment like the FBI. Taking everything from pies and pans and fans and cold night. Everything except the dog.
That's Matt.
Yeah, are you going to know who every single person
is? I'm a Brockhampton stan.
What? I don't know who everyone is. I only know a couple voices.
Okay, no, that's definitely Matt.
Okay, cool. The acoustic guitar.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
It's a bit of a different sound to...
To what?
To, I suppose, the saturations.
I mean, they're all like, saturation 1 and 2 were quite similar in like sound and structure. Mm. Saturation 3 was a bit more experimental.
Yeah.
And then Iridescence was really experimental.
Yeah, I told you, it's the nanny.
But,
right?
But they're not, none of them are Lils. So.
You know what I mean, though? It's a similar vibe. That's definitely something new. No one help me with my. Do I matter? I'm ecstatic. I'm depressed. Mother got special mess. Never had no halo. Chippy, I can.
His mother died.
The song's called No Halo. He just said No Halo.
Yeah.
Chippy, I can barely hack it out of bed. Time bomb under it, persuading you to hop in.
Options. You know, this is the thing with Merlin. He always has like the most animated and like. Over the top performance, but then when you listen to what he's saying, it's some depressing shit.
Right.
Like,
yeah.
A lot of the time.
Do you can you hear what he's saying?
Kind
he's talking
of,
about being depressed. I heard that. Yeah. Recognize his voice.
I don't know who that is. It sounds like a woman, but I know they've worked a lot with Ryan Beatty, who has quite a feminine voice. It might be him. It might be a woman.
I think it sounds like a woman to me.
Yeah, it does sound like a woman.
Maybe they've low-key worked with Beyonce again.
It's the fight on my night terrors. Now I smoke through the dreams. The pressure put me in the places where I'm stuck in the seams. They see my mouth and said the only way to breathe is to scream.
The pressure put me into places where I'm stuck in the seams.
Hmm.
That's really clever.
Mm.
That's dumb.
That's dumb.
Dumb is always... I remember, I think when Iridescence came out and he tweeted, he's like, I only spent 10 minutes on each verse. I'm like, how? You're a genius.
What? Yeah. Why would you even advertise that, though? That's... wow.
Went to church for the hell of it, stumbled in drunk and shit, been going through it again. Been talking to myself, wondering who I am.
Do you know what he said at the start of the verse?
What?
He said, I went to church just for the hell of it.
Oh.
Which happens to a lot of people who are just, they're like, yeah, you're Christian, you have to go to church, or you're this religion.
No, but just for the hell of it.
Yeah, just for the
hell of it.
Yeah, I know. That was what I was talking about.
Oh, the I'm hell talking of it. About. Yeah.
Wash it out of all of me to feel the fire. Maybe I'll be good for
it. Bareface.
I'm not a fan of that. The boy band stuff.
Are like you
the
mad?
Only bit I don't
are
like.
You mad? Bareface is. Oh.
No, but that's boy bandy.
They're a boy band. What do you expect?
I know. Bareface, the Irish one.
Irish. Yeah,
you, proper, can, you can tell.
His accent is like, I'm not going to do it because it'd be racially insensitive.
It's very Irish, yeah. Okay.
That would be beautiful.
Beautiful.
I think what they've done in contrast to the rest of their albums, the opener is usually like really punchy and like Heat is like the craziest song they made.
Right.
Gummy is like fun.
Mm-hmm.
Boogie's crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
New Orleans is like, we're back, bitches.
Mm-hmm.
And then this is like proper somber.
Yeah.
So I feel the album I feel is going to be quite, I don't know, quite like introspective.
Possibly, melancholic. Yeah, quite, emotional.
I mean, look at the cover.
I mean, yeah, exactly. So, I think they're trying to tell us something. And the production is quite minimal. It's quite straightforward.
I mean, what's it? The producers for Brockhampton, Jabari and Ramil, I think there's another one, but I can't remember the name. They're amazing. Mm. They're proper versatile.
Mm. Okay, the next one is Sugar.
Sugar.
Spending all my nights alone, waiting for you to call me. You're the only one I want by my side when I fall asleep. I move mountains on my own, don't need nobody, yo. Change your mind when I change my life, better start believing in myself. Spending all my nights alone, waiting for you to call me.
What was that instrument in the back?
I don't know what that instrument was, but did you hear the record scratch come back in?
The record scratch?
It was like the backwards record scratch.
Okay.
And that was all over Saturation 3.
Yeah, yeah.
So I don't know exactly what the meaning of the link is, but it's back.
It's back.
Again, it's a similar instrument with the acoustic guitar to the first one.
Yeah, it's probably going to be the whole thing. See, my worry now is that this whole album is going to be like the boy band cheesy which I don't like.
Wait until you hear Boy Bye.
Okay.
You're going to lose your shit.
Don't build it up too much, because then it's just going to be disappointing.
Okay.
No matter
Boy Bye
how
is
I
shit.
React.
It's the worst song.
Oh my god.
When I love you right, I love you right. Oh, baby, I'm sad. But I make it right, baby, I want you to know. Spend all my nights alone, waiting for you to call me. You're the only one I want by my side when I fall.
It reminds me of like a 90s R&B.
Yeah,
song.
A little bit, yeah.
It reminds me of, like, 3LW.
I don't know what that is.
Oh, okay. Never mind, then.
Okay.
Do you love me, love me, love me? Do you love me, love me, love me? Do you love me, love me, love me? Do you love me, love me?
Oh, next one's going on. Okay.
I felt that was a very like insecure song. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
We get like.
Maybe.
Do you love me? Love me. Do you know what? I'm glad that they're giving more, more time to Bareface, because a lot of his appearances felt like cameo-ish. Even though I love his stuff, it felt like, so I like that they're trying more things with him.
Okay. Cool. This is Boy Bye. So you've heard this. I haven't. It's only 2 minutes.
I haven't just
seconds.
Heard it. You've I think it's probably like one of my most played songs of the year already.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And one of my favourites.
Okay. There's so much pressure now.
Oh, God. It's so amazing.
Okay. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Divine me body. Everybody ask me how damn how to crush me. Look, man, I got the answer to question. If I dare you, probably never hear from me again. That's a promise, not a threat. Ain't no hashtag. Ain't even fresh. Hey. What you been suggesting? Hey. Learning no constitution. We don't need a minute. I could try to cock when I raise him out of 50.
It's beautiful. I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is.
Is it a sample or is it like...
I don't know what the fuck it is, but I love it. Shit bomb like a belly when it's pretty. Bonafide big bird looking like a yeti. Spin feet cheetah, that's real big kitty. Major eye judges, that's real ass feeling. I don't like slime, won't forget him, and I did it. Always out of shit like also, there's a music video for this. The music video is amazing.
What is it?
It's. I don't want to spoil it for you.
Oh, okay.
Just Matt's bit is like he's. You remember when David Blaine was like in that glass box.
Yeah.
He's like that. He's like in a glass box, like rapping to the camera. Mm. It's cool as shit.
Okay, cool. Acting like Regina, you a little bit dramatic.
I've been in the cockpit, I've been in the cabin. Do that. Mm. Acting like Regina, you a little bit dramatic.
That's good because I'm a t-shirt.
Regina.
Yeah, Regina George. She has that thing saying little bit dramatic.
Oh, I thought you were talking about your t-shirt.
No.
Oh,
no,
I was like
t-shirt.
David Bowie, Regina. What? My mama got me fucked up, my mama got me fucked up. My little nigga locked up, it's like a kumatata. Never like sci-fi, empathetic Wi-Fi. Keep it in the back room, hide it with my dry eye. My bitch is so pretty. I get cash like really. Tell the DJ man he ain't slick, cause he ain't playing his, he's silly. My bitch is so pretty. I get cash like my bitch is so pretty.
I can't listen to it if you're just singing it. Shush, God, this is supposed to be reaction. This is the year for so bad. What's that? Okay, that was more like it.
I love it.
It
so much.
That was more like it. Yeah, that was dope. But that's what I want for. I want that for every song on this album. I don't want all the boy band stuff.
Listen, yeah.
Oh, and variety. Okay.
It's a short one. This is Heaven Belongs to You.
Only 1:30. Immerse myself in discontent, hoping you can. That's a British guy. Who's that?
Keep going.
Only repent these things. It smells like ginger.
What you? It sounds like slow tie.
You think it's slow tie?
I think it's slow tie.
Okay. Sounds like ginger.
Sounds like ginger. He's not even from London.
No, he's from Northampton. Yeah, he's from my ends.
You're not from Northampton.
Yes, I am.
You're from Bedfordshire.
Which is very close to Northampton. Well done. They put the blame on me, but hey, it wasn't me. Like, God can judge me, but only God can see. I ain't being judged, no one judging me. And I'm the flurry, vision blurry, see soliloquies. I didn't get the memo, didn't CC me. Only CC me when I'm doing buggery. I didn't get the memo, didn't CC me. That's good. And if it weren't on TV, you wouldn't have ever seen.
Fuck God, I'm a dog backwards. Backwards. Fuck God, I'm a dog backwards.
Is this just slow tie or is this...
I think that's just slow tie.
Okay. Whole lot of shit and some bitches. Like... He sounds like he's high as shit.
He might be, I don't
That was really cool.
That reminded me of Where the Cash At? From Iridescence.
Yeah.
Low Tie has had a very good, if that is Low Tie, he's had a very good year. He's worked with Skepta, he's worked with Tyler Creator.
Yeah.
Now Brockhampton.
Yeah, he's having a good year.
He's having a good year.
That was cool. That was like a cool little interlude type thing. This is St. Percy. Do you know what? St. Percy's, is that from the Bible?
Maybe it's a reference to Percy Weasley.
I mean, he is ginger.
Exactly! I've cracked the code!
No. That sounded like bag.
That's what I'm talking about. I was going like, dum, 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 dum,
dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, dum, d
the same one you seen in the classroom. Ayy, we was chillin' in the style, making crowds move. Ayy, hangin' on your speaker, bangin' on your speaker, baby. Need to find a reason to make it, believe it, baby. Young Nola, PlayStation controller. My nigga saw Scotia, such a short quota. Police pull up on me, boy, I kept that cold shoulder. Cup running over for 100.
Always pull up on me, keep that cold shoulder. He's doing like a kind of Jamaican accent.
Who is this?
It's Kevin.
Right, okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah, up, he is.
And he said Young K, Kevin.
Okay.
But this beat is, oof, if I can call it a beat, is experimental
bass
as fuck.
It's just that bass. It.
Yeah.
Mm,
but nice. I heard, you know that, the ding, ding, ding.
Yeah, yeah,
that reminded me of Scooby-Doo 2 Monsters Unleashed. If you know, you know.
You're not going to expand on that at all. You're just going to drop that. And
no, there were like some, there were some instrumentals in that film that were sick.
Okay. What song is that?
I don't know.
I think I do know, but I...
Keep going.
Do that right, devil, I'm bamboozled. Yeah, legs go up behind the head like leopard and pushing. Love a chick, it's a lemons, it's a lemons. And they keep on hitting my niggas and quitting. They into legit, ain't to legit. Don't get on my list, I'm front of your best. You saying you're real, but I watch how you're acting. I can't be convinced. Smoking on my leg, I hit.
Big boy money, like you ready for. You be talking.
What song does this? Big boy money, no, but this voice, it was on Iridescence, so.
I know exactly
what
you're talking about. I know exactly what you're talking about. New Orleans, like, them go change to your neck, green man.
Yeah. That's what I'm
thinking. It's Bareface.
Okay.
Yeah.
So he's got a style.
Yeah.
This is sick.
This is sick.
I'm sorry. It's so hot here.
It's like 33 degrees or something.
It's so hot, and we have to keep the window closed for the sound, and I am sweating.
It's peak.
Okay, sorry. Let's carry on.
You really gon' run that dog. You be running like the snot dripping from your nose. That's the ice cream sugar.
Running like the snot dripping from your nose.
Like the sweat dripping from our
from my bowels.
Whoa. The way it broke down a little bit there was like it was like kind of like late 90s, early noughties kind of like R&B, NERD type thing.
Yeah.
I didn't mean for that to rhyme, but it did. This is sick.
You see what I'm saying about Merlin? He's probably talking about some dark shit, but then you hear him, he's like, Merlin, man! It's like,
because he kind of shouts, but I love it.
It's like when he came in on New Orleans, he's like, voodoo man! Mama took me to the church and I sang a hymn.
That's like exactly the same. Are they doing a callback to New Orleans in this song?
You went murder man, no, voodoo man!
Yeah, it's very similar, right? That was awesome.
Call him stupid.
That was awesome. Okay, so we've had a like couple. I love hype. Over the top, crazy Brockhampton. That's my favorite.
I like,
I think
all
my favorite Brockhampton song is Sister Nation.
Sister Nation.
Yeah.
That's a left field choice. Like the field's there, and your choice is in that field.
But I like it when they go off and go.
No,
crazy.
I love Sister Nation.
Yeah.
But my favorite Brockhampton song is I Can't Choose. It might actually be Tape. I'm not gonna lie.
I Can't Choose.
It might be Tape.
Okay, so this is If You Pray.
This was one of the singles that we listened to, but we can't really remember.
Was this the very first one?
I think this was the first one.
Okay.
I think this is the first one.
All right.
I remember it being good. Yes, I remember it. It's a little creepy one.
Hallelujah, holy lion, words of Judas. How I'm supposed to.
What, is that a trombone?
I think it is a trombone, yeah.
I got spirits in my heart that make my mom move like a swasta. Flow into the moment and avoid the melodrama. I gotta breathe. For a second, can't believe anybody's still twisted. My whole team is supposed to be Ricky.
Who's this?
Dom.
This is Dom.
This is Dom.
Okay. This is sick.
Operator like specialist. One to the two to the who are you sitting out projections with prejudice. My attention to detail to try and take no chances. We won't help you as if you stumble.
this is so they've definitely gone into their more experimental. Like, imagine pitching that, like, we're going to do some, like, really fast rapping, really cool rhythms and stuff. We're going to do it over, like, a single trombone line.
Yeah.
People will be like, well, what?
It's like when, on Jaden's album, one of the beats, it starts with him shaving his hair.
Okay.
And then the sound of the clippers turn into the beat. He raps over him shaving his head.
Yeah. I just feel like hip-hop's getting so experimental nowadays. Like, everyone's finding really cool little...
I think it's been experimental for a while, but it's breaking into the mainstream.
Oh, yeah,
now.
Definitely.
Watch your bag, don't leave your dough. Crack, they keep slipping through your space and watch it all collapse. Watch your bag, don't leave your dough. Crack, slipping through your space and watch it all collapse.
Why are you laughing?
Like, he's like, watch your bag, don't leave your dough. Cracked.
What is going on though? What instrument is this? What sound is this?
I don't know. You got a cool man like Romil.
Okay, alright. We'll do that after, yeah.
Sticky fingers at the door, bro. Jehovah, you whole bitch. Witness sadistic.
At the door. Jehovah, hello, bitch.
You said something witness.
I love Jehovah.
It will come again next time I take my belt off. Spank you, bad kid, bad scene. Not me, got me.
The sound effects are very...
Someone just got spanked to fuck in the song.
Yeah, are you sure this is
it? Yeah.
That was such a Radiohead sound.
That what? Do you know what it sounded
That's
like?
That's a Kid A sound.
Wait, go back. I swear that's the end of Paranoid Android.
Yeah. You might be right.
We
know that they love Radiohead anyway.
Yeah. Okay, but that second beat sounds like some lo-fi hip-hoppity beat to study to.
It sounds like it's going to be cool, so we've still got ages left of the song. A minute and a half.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm tired of making a fool out of me and you.
Who's that?
Better. I am actually not sure.
Well then.
Yeah.
Fake fan over here.
Yeah, fucking fake fan.
Better bet on it. Hey, you know better. Better.
This guy isn't in Brockhampton, is he?
I don't know.
It might
I actually don't know.
Some sort of sample or something. I think it's one of the dads. It sounds like it's from like a home video or something.
Yeah.
I want to look up what that end bit actually was, because I feel like that might have been something significant, but we don't know the context.
Even for Brockhampton, that's one of the strangest songs that they've made, I think.
Yeah.
I do believe
it's a very strange song. I don't think you're right in that was the first single. We can look
it up. There were three singles. There was Boy
Was
Bye.
That definitely the first one? Because I would have remembered that if I'd have actually listened to that.
So, okay, maybe it was I've Been Born Again first. But
yeah,
those,
probably.
I've Been Born Again, if You Pray Right, were definitely two that were released.
That's interesting that they released that because that was really strange. It was a strange song.
Yeah. Next song is Dearly Departed.
Which sounds like it might be a sad song.
Watch him come in and be like, big bands, the fuck bands.
I mean, that's what we hope for.
I pray I find you at the bottom of the hill. I pray I make it out of Texas. I pray my AC come back on. My mama suck outside the job. My sister just asked for a Lexus.
He's talked about supporting his family before. He's like, my sister just asked for a Lexus.
This is just not very, 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 very influenced by Frank Ocean.
I can see that.
I can see that. That was my first thought. It was like, he's doing a Frank. Okay.
Can Jesus send me a message? What's the point of having a best friend if you end up losing him? Well, don't view my text messages. Okay. Well, don't view my text.
What's the point of having a best friend if you end up losing him?
Oh, like Amir?
Exactly.
Oh, is Amir... I mean, Amir is dearly departed from the band.
So this might be a song about Amir. I don't know, because he got kicked out for sexual misconduct.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know exactly what he did, but I think that, obviously...
Like, I read all about it, I'm not gonna lie. So, it was all going on, because it was all going on Twitter, wasn't it?
Yeah.
That people were coming forward and talking about it on Twitter. I read it all.
Yeah, so obviously, whatever he did was deemed unacceptable. Unacceptable, and obviously he's a public person with a high profile, so they thought the best decision was to...
Yeah, because he didn't... Yeah. His actions weren't representing what they wanted the boy band to represent.
Yeah, and especially, like, they're a group of guys who speak openly against certain things.
Yeah.
But at the same time, if you just say if you put yourself in the shoes of Kevin, that's your best friend from school, and you're unaware that he's doing all these shitty things, and that's someone that you've probably confided in a million times, and then it's like, shit, I have to break off this. I have to break off this friendship for the betterment of me and my other friends and my career.
Yeah.
And it is, like, even though you recognise what he did is unacceptable, at the same time, that was my best friend.
Yeah, so there's still some sort of grieving process to it.
Definitely.
Yeah,
definitely.
Don't view my bad side, only get on the ground and show you motherfuckers the best side. Who am I? Who am I? Who am I?
He said, don't see my bad... He said something about... See. Yeah, yeah.
Don't view my bad side, only get on the ground and show you motherfuckers the best side.
Don't view my bad side, only on the ground and show my best side.
Yeah.
Which is what people do on Instagram, show the facade of their life, like their pristine, preem life.
But I mean, if he's talking about Amir, then he's talking about how he didn't show the fact that that was what he was like in a relationship. Yeah.
All I like, I made a meal off a lie and a lie, so I write another lie. RCA that no wasn't about.
Made a meal off a lie
and a lie and a lie.
Saturation 1, 2, and 3.
Yeah.
Mm.
Fuck.
Oh, no lies, but how me and my brother's been traumatized. And I must keep creating truths and hooks to get up out of this hell for myself.
Oh, I swear that.
Dog, I feel like I don't got anybody on my side no more. Highs to low, truth be told, it's hard to ignore. I'm afraid of people dying, rest in peace, Waka Ray Rita. Wish you could've took me to Japan, back 10 years, holding my hand, felt like 100 grand. Wish I'm letting...
He's definitely talking about someone specific.
Someone that passed away.
Yeah. Really. Who is this? Which member?
That's Matt.
Okay, it sounds like he's talking about someone specific.
I done shit on myself too much to not know how to move properly now. On the property now.
Yeah, I done shit on myself too much to know how to move properly now.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like a self-destructive type thing, really. Like you feel you're not worthy of success or something.
Mm-hmm.
How many sides to a story can it be when you saw it with your own eyes? I got all my thoughts out on records y'all won't ever hear. Try to give it time, find that truth trickles down.
Yeah.
So he said, how many sides
of a story can there be when you saw it with your own eyes?
You saw it with your own eyes.
Mm-hmm.
He says, I got, paraphrasing it, like, I got stuff I didn't say or I can't say.
Okay.
So do you think he had, I think that's Dom, do you think he had to hold back his want to protect Amir when all the shit in the public came out? Because obviously that's his friend. So
protect him what way?
So as in to like protect his image. Because obviously he didn't see it. So he...
They said there was, in part of the, as far as I can remember, in the different accounts of what happened, there were a couple of girls who literally said that Amir would treat them like shit and abusively in front of the other members of Brockhampton. And that they did nothing about it. So there were things like that.
I'm not going to comment. I wasn't there. I wasn't there. Okay.
Yeah. I mean, it sounds like a horrible, complex,
yeah, exactly,
messy situation anyway.
little bit I know the one who pulled the strings was once on my side. I had just moved to Texas, tried to make it right.
I know the one who pulled those strings was once on my side.
Right.
So, that's a myth. He was a manipulator.
Yeah.
Or, as people have come out and called him.
Yeah. If I knew what you would do to someone you want money
to, you wouldn't get it down. Watch for where you went. Sorry. If I knew who you would be, something, you wouldn't get a dime.
If I would know what you were gonna do to someone who wanted money to, you wouldn't get a dime. Because you never learn how to be a man, and it's not my fault, and it's not my problem anymore. That's just where you stand, that's just who you are, that's your cross to bear. You can talk to God, I don't wanna hear, motherfucker. Oh, that was the sound of him throwing down the mic and leaving. Are you okay?
God fucking damn, oh my God. God.
Yeah, this is heavy.
This is fucking heavy, man.
Heavy.
Fucking hell.
Such fucking a heavy hell. Song.
That was heavy. But
that was real heavy.
Fucking beautiful.
Yeah, it's powerful. But I can see how that was inspired by, like I say, it's inspired by Frank Ocean. To me, it reminds me of like Channel Orange type.
That did not remind me of Channel Orange at all.
But...
Let me hear you out.
Let me. I can't.
I'm going to let you finish.
Definitely the way Kevin was rapping at the beginning was a very sing-rappy style. It was like a Frank Ocean type rapping style.
Yeah.
But the instrument... I can't speak. I'm too hot to do anything. The instrumentation and everything and the vibe of it was like very like old, like, you know, classic stuff. Like Bowie inspired.
The that reminded me of like Pink Floyd or something.
Yeah, like that stuff like that, like classic kind of stuff. Okay.
But fucking hell.
Yeah, that was heavy. This is I've Been Born Again.
So this was one of the...
I think this is the one that I heard.
Once. Okay, yeah. I think this was the first one.
Okay. I've Been Born Again. I have been born again. Out on the day like a wild first man. It's a three-piece CC, bitch, you want a deal. It's better if I tried not to talk about the shit that's always on my mind. Money on
again, they're bringing, like, you hear that? Yeah. That was on, I could have got a job in McDonald's, but I like curly fries. It was on that song. Ducking down, hear me whine. Ooh, we outside now, milk carton in the back. We don't like to fuck around with them niggas in the back. Dancing like a bad bitch, love on top of my mattress. Hope the good Lord cash this, I ain't telling backwards. But rapping about dick still, and I lease a house still. Move my nigga out still. Rapping about dick still.
Is this Kevin?
Yes. Okay. Yeah. Miss my little niggas down low like a big wheel. Bitch, I wanna hit still. This shit for my partner. Them. Devil keep on robbing them. Miss my niggas down low like a big wheel. Because big wheels, they're like tricycles with the big wheel. You ride it low because your ass is like on the floor.
Mm-hmm.
And he's from Texas.
Right.
Down south. Like I'm Dennis Rodman. Like I'm Dennis Rodman. I'm in Texas for my partner. Cause I found him, I am blessed, man. Raking dividends, let the money stack. See you copycats, I ain't tripping, but copy that. It's a rap, keep my distance. Where's Waldo, but we win it. That room, oh my God, if you haven't heard it, it's a Pusha T song called Untouchable.
Okay.
It sounds just like that. It's like, doom, doom, doom. He's like, lyrically, untouchable, untouchable, what the fuck?
Okay.
That's how it goes.
That's nice.
Yeah. Sorry, what were you saying?
Who's this rapper?
I can't decipher. Because the voice is so manipulated and like deep.
I mean, yeah, okay.
So that's the most lit burlesque joint. Ever.
What song is that?
Who's it by?
It's a Brockhampton song.
Don't go running your mouth. It's queer.
There you go. Yeah. That's what it sounds like.
But you were like...
What are you talking about? I was dead on. We're going to watch this and I was dead on.
What are you talking about?
Dead on. Bitch slap. Is that what you said? Bitch slap. I don't understand why the first two songs were so boy bandy and then the rest has just like abandoned it. I was preparing myself for a boy bandy album,
like,
and then
thematically it's similar. It is thematically dark and it's about loss.
But
and
the
stuff
instrumentation
like that.
Is much more like harks back to saturation and iridescence, which is good.
It's all good. It's all gold.
Good.
Gold.
Right, this one is the title.
Ginger.
Song. Ginger. Let's go.
The beat reminds me. Keep the bag in the cup. Add it up. I like it. I like
it. Mood is always better whenever you're not around. Fucking up the weather and you fucking.
Mood is always better when you're not around.
Cut those toxic ties.
Someone told me that. That would. Whoa.
I'll be like, what the fuck?
That cuts deep. That does.
Tell me, goddamn, what got mad before? I don't even love no more. I don't even trust no more.
This bit's so like clubby commercial.
I swear,
isn't
on
it?
This album, Matt has been like maybe the standout.
Do you think?
Yeah, Matt's been. Everyone else has been like, and then Matt's been like. Come back!
It sounds like it was children.
Yeah. They have used like children, like remember on Sam Marcos? I want more. I think that was like a children's choir or something.
Yeah. Okay, cool. The next one is Big Boy.
Big Boy Bye.
No, just Big Boy.
I still remember writing words down, trying to get them all out of my mouth. Big boy, you a big boy now. Big boy, you a big boy now.
If I had another, I'm a bad motherfucker. Got love for my mother, the city that protect me. You could come around, hold it, who's the
I swear that's the most auto-tune I've heard on a Brockhampton song.
No, have you ever heard a fake? There was loads of auto-tune in that song.
Okay, well, yeah. Is this Kevin with auto-tune?
I think so, yeah.
Okay. This got us on the kind of thing going on.
Maybe it's a car indicator.
No, like a. Anyway, it's Colby. It's Colby. It's mouth sounds.
Take my breath away. Don't let me fade away. May die before I wake. Not the type to play.
If I die before I wait. What is that from? If I die before I wait.
I think it's just a saying. A common saying.
Is it? I think it's
maybe from the Bible. From I don't know. I ain't never read Bible.
No, it's from a song.
I'm weak and I'll say it proud. Build me up. Hold me down. Let's air it out.
Beautiful though, these chords.
They are
the
beautiful.
High note, that's beautiful.
I swear, Joba is he's the most versatile because he contributes to production as well.
Right, okay.
And he sings, and he raps, and he does the. Remember, I break your neck so you can watch your back! Fuck you! But then he comes in with the.
Better get some grades up if you want to finish high school.
He does everything.
I like the subject matter of this sort of song where, like...
They're embracing the vulnerability.
Yeah, like, they're questioning, like, toxic masculinity and stuff, aren't they? And
That's why I thought at the start of the song it's going to be satirical. It's like, I'm a big boy, don't cry around me.
But they're saying it's all bullshit and it's damaging. And it's,
he was like, I'm weak and I'm proud.
Yeah, it's cool. What a day.
Was that not a Mad Max Fury Road reference? They went, what a day. What a beautiful day!
Oh my god.
We was riding in the dark, you were putting your legs up. Girl, I don't know, let me ask you to stay shut.
So something about legs up, something, something, stay shut.
I didn't catch that.
Maybe they're talking about slut shaming too.
Maybe. I wouldn't be surprised.
Good. Was that Hotline Bling?
That sounds like Hotline Bling.
Okay, that was really good. Yeah, really experimental. So this is the penultimate song. This is called Love Me For Life.
Love of my life.
No, love you me heard for life.
Me, I know.
Okay.
It's not Hotline Bling.
It sounds a bit it sounds like a bit it.
Like... Sounds like a video game.
What I gotta do, keep it real with you, stuck inside my truth.
Spinning. Like that just flow just reminds me of Mona Lisa.
I see niggas in this bitch, starting, bumping, battles, getting drunk with these. I'm gonna stop before I do the whole song.
This will be a time song.
Couple rainbows, my little halo, think it's J-Lo. Say so. Anyways, gotta go. Disregard what I say. Rain is all sprinkle some over the shoulder.
Look at him.
That's Joba. I told you he's versatile as
he
fuck.
He is, isn't he?
He's okay. He's the wild card. That's what he is.
Okay.
Sensitive, abrasive, stab you in the face. Keep a blade, have a say.
Sensitive, abrasive, stab you in the face.
Okay.
Fill my loads with bleach. Couple stains in a game.
Fill my load with bleach. With bleach.
With bleach? Why did you say it like that?
Because the bleach was is their really famous song.
I know, but why did you say it like that?
No, because that's how he goes. He goes, fill my load
with bleach. Oh,
it was
and
like,
and then
it was like out of the rhyme scheme.
Okay, yeah, and then he before that he talked about sad songs follow him.
Well, there you go.
Ooh, got the feeling. Tell me why.
Oh, haunting me. Lot to say. People hate wearing blindfolds. Where did I go?
People hate wearing blindfolds.
People hate wearing blindfolds.
Yeah, so
without no, really
without
knowing
or without research, without knowing what the fuck you're talking about.
Right, yeah.
You're like, you're a big hater.
Slip and set it off. I just made a deposit. CDG in my closet. Shoot me a share for Trayvon Martin. Take Ali and Bobby Martin.
What did he say about Trayvon Martin?
I told you, he sounds like he's going crazy, but he's talking about
yeah, he's
some
talking
fucked
about
up
really,
shit.
Yeah.
Get home from a split set pocket. She wanna know why my wrist so rocky. Blast, blast on me. Photo copy. My weed at the party. Shoot me a share for Trayvon Martin. Take Ali and Bobby Marley.
Said shoot me
something yeah
for safety or something. I don't know what he said, but he said shoot me something. Trayvon Martin, then he mentioned Bob Marley as well. Bob Marley was a shot, but
I think he's definitely he's one of the members where it's really worth looking up his lyrics. Like
yeah,
what he's actually
it's
written.
Like when like in Sweet, everyone remembers when he's like, "Don't call me stupid, that ain't the way my name." And then he goes and he's like he's talking about a civilian shot in Third Ward. He's talking
right,
about like
yeah,
gang
yeah.
violence in the next bar.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
But you don't immediately like recognize it because he's just like so like animated.
Yeah. I think they're talking about their fans. Do you think they're talking about their fans?
What if shit hits the fan? You still
about
a fan?
Being haters. Yeah. That's
maybe
best.
Yeah.
Interesting one.
That was very interesting. It's the last song already. Unfortunately, I want more.
You want more, do you? No, I think this is. Okay. I think like 45 minutes is,
this
like
is
a good length for
do,
an album.
Do you know what? Do you know what always like astounds me is that you'll have a rapper or like they'll be like, yeah, I'm bringing out my new album. It's got 28 songs. It's 130 minutes. And it's one guy or like two guys.
Yeah.
This is like six different people.
Yeah.
And they've condensed it.
They condensed it
to like 40. Their albums are like 50 to 45 minutes.
Yeah, yeah. I think there's a lot of artistry in editing and condensing.
Yeah.
Like 100%.
Yeah.
But even like making a video, like editing is like half, if not more, the work.
Yeah.
So I feel like they must make so much stuff in the studio.
Yeah.
And then they have to proper condense it down and make it coherent and make it thematic. Yeah.
Yeah. Obviously, there's some albums which demand that length that have to be like longer than usual ones.
Yeah, yeah.
But in the most case, you need to be under an hour.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. So this is called Victor Roberts. Do we know who Victor Roberts is?
I have no idea who Victor Roberts
is. They might tell us.
A historical figure, a rapper.
Who knows?
Maybe he's on the song.
Maybe. Let's see. Victor Roberts.
My fucking Power Rangers couldn't protect me from that LAPD kick, though. Motel pick poke, swim through the living room.
That is not anyone from Brockhampton.
Okay.
100%.
So you think this is Victor Roberts?
I mean...
Probably one of their dads.
One of their dads? Maybe it's one, I don't know. One of their dads?
It's
one of their mates.
Sounds like an older person.
It sounds like, yeah, I don't know. I don't know who Victor Roberts is, but it's not one of them.
To the bedroom looking for great dope. My papa looking at my mama looking at that closet like that shit go. But the fat crack different than coke, plus the smoke wasn't close enough to choke me.
He's talking about crack.
Yeah, this is a very, very unique flow.
Yeah, it's cool though.
It is, yeah.
Yeah.
Now I know it's police, you gotta do what you gotta do, but this my family, all I got is us, my nigga. My whole mother just shot at us, my nigga. This is why we here, and I don't fuck with niggas I don't know. Mr. Policeman, so policeman, we got what we need. Let's let him be.
Thank God for my bitches still sticking with me. Thank God when I'm talking, know you listen to me. And if you're hurting,
yourself with my heart.
Thank God for my bitches still sticking with me. Thank God when I'm talking, know you listen to me. Thank God that I'm built for the...
Again, he's talking about his their relationship with their fans. He's like, thank God for thank God you're listening.
Yeah.
Thank God for me. Thank God for me. Thank God for me.
That sounds like Ryan
Beatty. Thank God for me. Thank God for me. Thank God for me.
Wow. Well, that was so emotional.
It was, yeah.
I wanted to cry the whole time. That was so emotional. Okay. What are your thoughts on the album?
I'm just happy that I'm listening to your Brockhampton album.
Okay.
I'm just happy.
Okay. Yeah, I thought that was really good. There were definitely some, there were standout tracks for
they
me.
They are five for fucking five.
Okay, chill. Chill. There they can't some standout
do
it tracks, but
tell me how they can good. Do wrong. Okay. They can't do it.
Yeah.
It's like...
Yeah, okay, cool. That's what we thought of the album. Let us know in the comments down below what you thought.
Make sure to like, subscribe, and dong the bell.
We'll see you next time. Bye.